Thank you for joining me. Today I'm going to be discussing the yoga pose Ardha Chandrasana, which is also known as half moon. In order to do this pose, which is a standing pose, I like to have blocks. So if you have blocks, go ahead and grab them. Another great way to do this pose is with the wall. I'll show you more on that in a minute. Let's start with the blocks. So I want to let you know, when I do my Ardha Chandrasana, I ground down through my feet, I get into Warrior Three first, then I rotate open. Okay, and I'm going to be using the blocks throughout because that's what my body requires to stabilize. If you don't need the blocks, that's cool too, you don't have to have them. But for those who maybe are starting out, if you have blocks, go ahead and grab them and I'll show you how to get into this pose. So we'll start off, heels right under the sits bones, nice and lifted. Take a moment here, find a good Tadasana. So you want to feel yourself press down into the mat, because as you press down, you should feel a length happening at the outside of your hip here, okay? You should feel that kind of lifting up and then the ribs lift up away further. So we're creating a nice long body and a nice long side body here. And when we have that length, the belly button comes on into the spine. Now I'm using these blocks as extensions of my arms. If I had the flexibility and didn't need the blocks, then I wouldn't have them in my hands. Or if I didn't need quite so much, I might switch them over to a different level, okay? But I'm gonna start off with them the long ways. So nice and lifted, we're gonna come into our Warrior Three first. So ground down, press the floor away, belly button to the spine, let the leg lift up, and I'm gonna hinge forward and set my blocks down. Now as I do this, I can really refine. I can really feel my grounding leg press the floor away. I can scissor the inner thighs, I can draw my belly button to my spine, and then I can push the floor away, hand to the hip first, so that you can feel your pelvis rotate open. Don't worry about the height of your back leg. Just worry that that foot is flexed at the ankle. Now, take a moment here before changing your arm, and I want you to try to find a nice upper back bend. So get the shoulders stacked on top of each other, soften the upper back, and then go ahead and reach the arm. Make sure, don't let that head pull forward. And then when you're ready to come out, belly button to the spine, we come back to our Warrior Three, bend the legs, set it in, and you can come on up, okay? So for the other side, I'm gonna turn around so that you can see that openness. We ground down, push the floor away, belly button to the spine, anchor through your foot, come into your Warrior Three. Take a moment to refine. Scissor the inner thighs. Flex that back foot. And then when you're ready, you push the ground away. Let your hand come to your hip. Rotate open. Find your upper back extension. Ooh, I'm going over. Ah, that's okay. That'll happen. When you go over, re-engage. Start over. Push the floor away, come back up. Find the upper back bend. And reach your arm up. And when you're done, draw into your core. Rotate back to center and set the foot down. Okay, so I mentioned about a wall. This wall is really not ideal. It's a half wall, and furthermore, it's kind of got this crown molding, but I really, really love doing half moon at the wall. So I'm gonna do it just to show you guys how you can do it at your home. So if you have an open space of wall at your house, go ahead, come up to the wall. You wanna get very near to it. I'm probably like 3 or 4 inches away. What we're looking for is enough space so that as you rotate, your glutes can have space to move, basically, but then also be able to quickly find contact with the wall. Okay, so we get set up, and we're gonna, and again, with this molding up top, it kind of messes things up because that's a few inches that it's pushing me out. But come into your warrior three, find that scissor, push the floor away, and then when you come on up, boom, connect your heel to the wall, connect your glutes to the wall, connect the back of your head to the wall, and then you can reach up and whoo, connect the back of your hand to the wall. And this is really liberating. When you do this pose, it's really liberating. It takes all of the guesswork away from you about, oh, am I in enough spinal extension? Oh, is my leg at the right height? Oh, is my arm up enough? When you have that support from the wall, it really helps you to get into the position you need to be in so that you can take that later and move it to your mat and find it. So try it with the wall if you'd like. Otherwise, try it with blocks or don't. But I do recommend that you come into it from warrior three first so that you can find that scissoring and that engagement, find that stability in the outside of your hips before you get the rotation. I hope that you've enjoyed this video. If you have, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Also, you can find me on Pinterest, Facebook, and at my website, www.custompilatesandyoga.com. Thank you.